have a suspicion, is still the largest ongoing furry convention in the world. I cannot say that with authority. I'm going to have to ask the chef over there, do you have any authoritative answer for us how we're doing so far?
Oh, we have an authoritative answer on that. We were the largest furry convention in the world on pre-registration alone.
Oh my God.
Right now, our current registration total is 3,653 attendees. Another couple hundred, we will be the biggest furry convention that ever was. It's all thanks to you fine folks. Next year, I want even more pre-registration. Remember, pre-registration means short lines.
Let's get right into the fun, pleasant things. I'd like to introduce a few folk who have been good enough to join us this year. We wanted to know, who can we bring in if we're going to have a theme, the modern Stone Age furries? Let's talk about the furries of the past. You know, the long ago past. Well, one of the names that, of course, is going to come up very, very frequently when you talk about the long ago past and add anthropomorphics to it. First, of course, is Fred Flintstone. The second is James Gurney, creator of Dinotopia. I can say all sorts of wonderful things about the man. We always are a little bit worried when a guest of honor comes in, and you know the question. How will the guest take to this? My understanding, if I heard correctly last night, Mr. Gurney, did you not at one time ride a unicycle through Berkeley wearing a gorilla suit? Please come up here, sir. Please. Mr. James Gurney, ladies and gentlemen. So, let the folks grab a microphone and say a few words, please.
Hello. Nice to meet you all. Great to be here. And yes, it is true. When I was a student at UC Berkeley, there was a big sign at the edge of campus that said, no skateboard and no bicycles. But it didn't say no unicycles. So I could get to class pretty quickly that way. And I could also get to class faster if I wore my gorilla costume, which I made out of latex and fur. And I put a security guard uniform on that, because then I could go behind the scenes anywhere. So the minute I came here, I felt right at home, and I'm just blown away by the creativity of what you guys have done. So thanks for the invitation.
For a number of you, for us, it's cherished childhood memories. How many people here remember such amazing shows as The Great Space Coaster? Good old Mr. Rogers Neighborhood, filmed right here in Pittsburgh. Between the Lions. What? Bear in the Big Blue House. The list goes on and on. Anything you have likely seen on television that involves puppets has likely had the magic hand of Mr. Jim Martin associated with it. Mr. Martin, would you care to come up here and say hello to us?
Hello, everyone. Thank you for inviting me to Anthrocon, and I should let you know that I am a Pittsburgher, and I have lived here all my life, so thank you for coming to my hometown.
We did a check. All right. Well, we are extremely happy, extremely honored to have our fine guests here. They have brought along their wives and families. As a matter of fact, so behave yourselves.
Full art show getting set up right now. It'll be open for your viewing pleasure starting today at 2 p.m. At last count, we have at least 165 artists participating. We would encourage you to vote. Each year we have a Popular Choice Award, as well as various other awards given out by the guests of honor and the drunken old fool in the middle there. There are Popular Choice ballots available at dinner sign-up. Pick up a ballot and vote. The deadline for that is Saturday at 6 p.m.
Not my fault, Peter. Keep talking.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Pittsburgh again for another Anthrocon. As always, if the city welcomes you, we're happy you're here. So have a good time, be safe, and behave.
But in having fun, if you get killed, it makes it not fun for us. And unfortunately, every once in a while, somebody has some fun, and in having fun, they make it impossible for us then to allow other people to have fun, if you know what I'm saying. For example, the management of the convention center has told us the rooftop area. We are not going to have access to the fourth floor of the rooftop. Scheduled events up there will take place, but at other times the roof is going to be closed to the public. They did not want to do that, and I was there. Emily, on our behalf, begged and pleaded with the general manager, but he was quite firm. And perhaps he was right when we found an Anthrocon attendee hanging out over the railing over the river last night. Remember what we said about it only takes one person to spoil it for the rest? That gentleman, by the way, I have his badge, and very, very shortly I will have his ass. The Westin's a very classy hotel. They really don't like people putting things on doors. I know it's sort of a tradition at furry conventions to tape a sign to the door that says, "Hi, this is, you know, this guy's room." We really cannot have you doing that. I apologize, I know it's fun, but you see, in the past, people did things like they used duct tape on the things, and thus the manager said, "Oh, okay, guys, please don't tape anything to doors. Even what you think is lightweight tape causes damage." So if you have used duct tape on your door sign, if that is you, make sure it ain't there in the next 5 minutes. Do you understand? There are some things I don't think I need to tell people, you know. Don't hang off the roof. Don't use duct tape on doors. Don't smoke in the Westin. The Westin is a non-smoking hotel. If you're a smoker, I apologize, I respect your rights, but respect ours too, please. We are finding cigarette butts in the stairwell. They should not be there. And just as with everything else, if it turns out I've got your cigarette butt, later on I will have your butt. All right? Thank you.
If you can see this, they're a little smaller. They have been laser etched on alderwood this year by the fine folks at Monoceros Media. So thank you to Tucker. If you are a fursuiter, this is how you will get one. You must show up in fursuit at the info desk after opening ceremonies has concluded. Can't go now, they won't do it. After the ceremonies have concluded, you must be in fursuit. You must show your con badge. They will take the number off the badge and scratch it off a list. They will then give you one of these badges, at which point that badge number may not get another one. These are all serial numbers. The largest number this year is number 800. Number 800 is not there. It is in the charity auction, and it is available to anyone, including non-fursuiters, if you wish to bid on it. All right, so folks, this is a presentation. This is a gift to the board of directors, as well as to all of you. This is a presentation to help open Anthrocon 2010.